Damn, it's a crab.
Get him. I don't like crabs.
Money, 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 money.
Okay, so we have one more part in this whole area, so we're gonna get it today. So what we need to do is get the yellow Pikmin.
When do you get the black Pikmin?
Ryan, there's no black Pikmin in this game.
What?
Yeah.
No hell was raised about that? Nothing. No one questioned that?
No, because it was the early 2000s when people didn't give a shit.
Sure, there are yellow people in this game and Pikmin with noses, which we all know who that represents.
Money, money, money. Oh, god damn it.
We can get a Christmas wreath, too.
We can't spend that much money.
I'll pay for it.
No, remember what Mr. Krabs once said. Money, money, money.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Shit, dude, is that Mr. Krabs?
I got him.
Dude, nice. Money, money, money.
Here we go. Yum, yum, yum.
Yum, yum, yum.
Gotta get your shit.
Yeah, dude, get some on my shit, dude. Nice.
No.
You got it, dude.
Money, 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 money.
Dude, in the name of Mr. Krabs. Kill him, dude. Get him good. Hit him with the Quan, dude.
Is this the Quan?
That's the Quan.
Who's Silas? Which is the first book of the Bible that lists the Ten Commandments?
Exodus, right?
Sure.
Isn't Exodus? Yeah, Exodus.
I don't know. Exodus
was the book of Moses.
Yeah, Deuteronomy is like a really messed up book of the Bible. Deuteronomy is where like all the really shitty stuff is.
In the episode of SpongeBob where he's like walking on the beach, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, I thought like I had debates about it with my cousin. I thought he was going Deuteronomy.
Yeah, you told me that like a year ago, how you thought he would just Deuteronomy.
SpongeBob.
Dude, I'm not gonna lie, when I watch those fucking, like, the videos, when people do, like, the CG, like, stories of, like, Minecraft, I get a little wiggle in my pants.
Yeah, futuristic hub, dude.
Yeah,
wait, who's the person that does, like, the SpongeBob, like, roleplay? What is that?
Oh!
Where he, like, plays as Jack, it's like Patrick, and it's like,
oh, this tastes so good. Oh, hi, SpongeBob, did you put anything?
I'm gonna go over and talk to Squidward.
Yeah.
Hey, Squidward, how are you today? Oh, I'm good. You see SpongeBob? He's really ticking me off. Oh, wow, Squidward, you're such a jerk. Anyway, so
He starts every episode with, oh boy, this is some good. And then it's either like a Krabby Patty, a sandwich, or a cake. One episode started with him making a sandwich. He's like, a cheese? A slice of pizza? What can I make with this?
I love those Minecraft roleplay videos.
There's
this one guy.
Good.
We talked about it before, but he's like, he did a Minecraft high school role play where he's just like, hey, baby, let's go into the locker room. Cool, I'll get my stuff. But one of the episodes is like, baby, there's something fucked up going on. There's a shooter in school. You can hear like shots going like,
what?
And, like outside the door, he's like, oh, this is really messed up. He's here to kill us. It's like, whoa. Yeah.
They did a straight school shooter role play in Minecraft.
Yeah, what? It's really funny.
Can we watch that tonight?
Yeah, totally, dude.
Chris, that's not funny, dude. That's like really fucked up.
No, it's funny because it's Minecraft.
Okay. What about Chris?
Yeah, did that turn you over, Matt?
Yeah, no, it's
anything in Minecraft is funny.
Like you could take any horrible event, like you could perform
off lady's face in Minecraft.
Chris showed us this amazing video that has like 43 million views and it's called SpongeBob in Real Life.
Two.
Yeah, the second one. There's two of them where this kid just went out and like just edited SpongeBob like into his everyday activities.
It's done really well.
Yeah, it's really well made.
It's got like decent animation. He did his lighting really well.
The animated characters, like his filming was a bit like
yeah, but it's funny and entertaining.
Yeah, he was very talented with the animation.
Besides his acting, you know.
He gets out of the I love his intro scene. It's the best part.
When he is his epic introduction to himself.
He's like driving down the road with his hand on the wheel and
his
elbow on the window. He's like nodding his head all cool and he's playing that song
that
laughing my fucking
song.
Ass off by Hello. It's like you today?
Yeah. Dude, that's gonna copyright, Chris. Shut the fuck up.
That sounded so similar to the song we might get flagged, so might have to cut that out.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'll be careful. But yeah, I like that video.
It's a good video.
I like
dude.
Videos like that.
I need to see more like
Sonic in real life.
You've shown me, you've opened my eyes, Chris, to so many good videos that I would never have found before I met you. And
it's okay.
I don't know, man. It's just like
are you gonna fucking come or something?
It has personality.
It does. I mean I couldn't have thought that up. I've seen your penis many times. In fact, in a podcast, you put it right in my face.
You didn't think about, wow, that looks just like a traffic cone and a pencil eraser.
And you know what? When I saw that, I kind of got that same feeling that when I hear Kronk's voice.
Yeah. It's like, when you hear it.
I mean, I guess I know what you're talking about. Not about your penis, but that feeling when you hear Kronk's voice.
Yeah.
I guess?
It's like, it's very, like, recognizable.
Is that Patrick Warburton that does Kronk's voice?
Yes, he...
Now, Peter.
Yeah, that's Patrick.
Here we go, getting some Here's parsley. I wish Patrick Warburton did Patrick's voice.
Dude, I wish I could meet SpongeBob and Patrick in real life.
Well, you can, Ryan. You can go watch the hit YouTube video, SpongeBob in Real Life, episodes 1, 2, and the brand new one, episode 3.
The guy looks like Bo Burnham's younger brother.
He does. And honestly, like, that kid, as slightly off those videos may be, he's not bad at After Effects. For what he's doing. I mean, like, obviously he could be better, but he's probably better than me.
I like when he did the kind of puppet tool thing to animate a PNG image of himself.
Oh, yeah.
In the invisible boatmobile.
Guys, if you know what we're talking about, just go look up SpongeBob in Real Life, episode 1, and then watch the trilogy. It's really good. I'm already doing way better.
Trilogy.
It's a fantastic trilogy.
What were you doing last time? You were just...
I think I was just distracted by whatever you were talking about.
Who's the guy that made the real-life SpongeBob?
Oh, yeah, dude!
Who's that guy?
He commented on an episode of Super Mega Cast after
horrifying.
We talked about him.
It's really good.
Dude, this guy made, like, a video
SpongeBob
where, like...
and Patrick go to real life?
Yeah, they come into real life.
Like, Kentucky or whatever.
Yeah.
Wait, but no, like, what are they? Are they little characters that they hold on, like, puppets?
Them.
Or they...
No, they're
he animates
They're
them.
Cartoons.
They're cartoons, but they're in real life.
Oh, I thought you meant, like, he created costumes that they wore to...
That would be even
horrifying.
Let me show Tucker the clip.
We need to watch SpongeBob.
It'd be like Shrek the Musical, yeah. SpongeBob the Musical?
Have you not seen Shrek the Musical, though?
I have spent as much time as I needed.
I've seen all of it. I've seen it all the way through. And I think you should.
Love it? Was it a heart? It felt.
It was an experience.
You know,
God damn it, dude!
What happened?
SpongeBob in real life? This dude got some fucking views on this.
How many views does he have?
All right, episode 1, 66 million.
Jesus.
Episode 2,
what?
60 million.
Good God.
That's Jesus so Christ, Jonathan Chase.
He's doing
okay,
great.
But reason I like this video is because, like, the scene where he, like, where he introduces himself, he drives up in his mom's, like, minivan, and, like, he puts this, like, epic dubstep music to make it, like, a really dramatic opening. And then it's like, have a nice
day. You gotta press this.
How are you today? That's what it is. Okay, hold on. Let me pull this shit up.
Yeah.
We gotta watch this. Like, nothing but love and respect to this guy because he fucking
put an effort.
Dude,
there's shadows in and shit.
And he probably made a shit ton of money off of these, man. Jesus Christ.
I mean, if copyright infringement didn't.
Okay, here it is. Here it is. Ready? He drives up and it's like, and he like shows himself driving. Hold on.
How are you today?
Oh man.
He watches the four wheelers passing by.
He looks like Bo Burnham.
He's got that like slight smirk.
He looks like a young Bo Burnham, doesn't he?
Maybe this is Bo Burnham, dude. That's how it got so many views.
Yeah, now he's making a A24 movie, which I'm excited to see. I think it comes out this week.
What's
it called? Yeah, eighth grade.
Eighth grade.
I got inspiration from Alec Baldwin. Not that I like Alec Baldwin. I think he's a huge asshole. If you see videos of him with like, well, I don't know. Maybe looking back, I could understand how paparazzi could get really annoying. But I don't know. I just heard he's a big asshole.
Well, he's also, you know, drunk. Yeah. He was mean to his daughter one time.
Was he?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't hear that.
There's recordings of it.
There's a bunch of.
He pulled the David Hasselhoff in a sense, a Mel Gibson,
where he got
but
drunk
on a lower standard.
He got drunk and then ate a cheeseburger on camera, laying on the floor shirtless.
Yeah, what's with all these, like, you got Mel Gibson,
fuck,
did I say Neil Patrick Harris, or I didn't
hear Neil Patrick
what
Harris.
What did I say? I said,
Mel Gibson, fuck, dude.
SpongeBob guy, they wrote him.
Tom Kenny?
They wrote him in SpongeBob movie.
David Hasselhoff.
Yes, sorry, yeah. I don't know why I said Neil Patrick.
The two are closely related.
Yeah, they look very similar here. Look at them.
Yeah, they look pretty similar. Remember at the end of the SpongeBob movie when Neil Patrick Harris came and took them back to Bikini Bottom? Jesus Christ.
Didn't they stab his butt?
No, he fired them out of his ass.
Oh my god. No, he fired him out of his pecs, dude.
Not his ass.
He squeezed his tits together.
That would have been
fired
too inappropriate.
Him back into Bikini Bottom.
I really enjoyed that scene.
Dude, the first SpongeBob movie is legitimately...
it's great.
A fun, good time.
I saw it in theaters with my mom, and my mom cried at the part when
they dry up.
Yeah, when they're drying up. That was sad.
Water!
Like, because, you know, you've known these characters for years and years and years, and then seen them...
Since the 90s.
Yeah, and seeing them on the big screen in what could be their last moments together, you just see all these memories flashing back in your mind and all the good times and laughs they brought, and you see them, like, dying, but they're like, you know what?
They're happy about it.
We're happy because we're dying together. And it's just, holy shit, dude.
And you also feel bad for them because you don't feel like they're completely aware of nothingness that is death.
It's like in this moment, it's like they've always been so innocent, but now it's like they still have their innocence, but you know that deep down they're fully aware of death and its implications and the grasp it has on them.
Have you reached?
So we don't have a lot of wall art in our apartments, and I'm trying to like commission Chris to do like a portrait of Squilliam tentacles with like a very detailed portrait of Squilliam with two big black floppy cocks on his shoulders, just resting on his shoulders, and he doesn't mind.
I'm gonna do it.
Will you still do it?
I will do it for you.
If you actually make it, I'll go to like one of those websites that puts it on a canvas, and yeah. I'll legitimately buy it and put it on our wall.
I'll totally do it for you.
Dude, can I buy one of those like fancy fucking frames for it?
Yeah.
Oh. This is the last one.
Is it?
Yeah.
So no more envelopes?
Wait, Ryan, once again, Israel is preparing for war with Hezbollah.
Holy shit! Dude!
Yes!
We have to hang this up.
Thank you.
Matt, we have to hang this up.
Yeah, we do.
Dude, there's a letter on the back.
Like, I have to censor this, though. This is, it's Squilliam tentacles with two big black cocks.
Do you have to censor it?
Yes.
Can you do like a...
It's gonna get age restricted. Chris S., thank you so much for this, man. I think we got some good shit today. We got some good shit. You guys are the best. Send us stuff to our P.O. box. Here is the address. It's on screen right now. Send that to the P.O. box. And stop! You're making me have to send it! That's a pain in my ass!
I'm sorry.
But thank you guys for everyone that sent stuff. We are going to do another one of these as soon as we get more stuff in the mail. So send it to our P.O. box. Stop!
I'm so sorry! I'm so sorry!
Fucking asshole.
You're just gonna have to.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to sit there and edit. I have to move the sensor, the pixels around.
Say goodbye!
Bye!
What about a Davy Jones twist around slam down?
Davy Jones twist around slam down? Okay, well, this one is mythological. It can never be done in real life. It can only be presented through fan art or fan fiction.
Okay.
So it's the Davy Jones spin around slam down? What was it?
I think it was twist around slam down. Okay, whatever. Something like that.
Whatever that was. So it's Davy Jones and SpongeBob.
Okay, yeah, I like that.
Okay, and SpongeBob has his asshole like spread open, like he has his hands on each.
It's
ass.
Very porous,
he has a hand
very
on
large.
Yeah, has a hand on each ass cheek, and each one is putting the same amount of effort into spreading each cheek. So
yeah, so he's got a large diameter,
and it's equally spread. It's not like one half of the asshole is a little
dilated.
Yeah. So and then the little part, you know, the little ghost end of Davy Jones because he doesn't have feet.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
He. Like, SpongeBob sucks that a little bit into
his anus.
Into his anus. And then he starts just violently, like, shaking his ass and slamming Davy Jones back and forth. That's the Davy Jones turnaround, slam down, whatever that is.
Wow, that's good, dude.
Yeah.
Let's see some fan art of that, please.
Gee golly, is that Patrick Stewart's house? Stewart, God fucking damn it.
Patrick Stewart?
Hey,
hello.
100,000 is a really big number, and we didn't think we would get this many subscribers since April.
Let's give a big round of applause for Let's Plays for being so popular on YouTube. It's the only way we made it.
So we prepared this little, it's the first time we've ever shown this, a little, I don't even know what you'd call it, just a little feature-length
presentation.
Yeah.
It's been, you know, months in the making. We've prepared for this moment, so we hope you enjoy it. A lot of work went into this.
Yeah, a lot
so,
of work.
So, we hope you enjoy it. Roll the clip. LeBron James.
Come in. Who are you?
I'm SpongeBob. Who are you? I'm LeBron James.
Getting scared that you try to move away, just like, yeah. Today we're just talking about transforming eyes. Getting scared that you offended them, and at the same time, misreacting to what they say at your brother. You start to react and you realize you're wrecking as well.
Barry, what are you featuring special guest Barry? Barry, come on.
You're gonna give us 10 more things.
Thank you.
Ow, fuck.
Give me your best, just give me SpongeBob.
You fuck.
Come on, man. What are you waiting for?
I don't know.
Hi, Pat.
Tom Kenny is just staring in fucking awe at his computer if he's watching right now.
I can't.
Hey, Tom Kenny.
I purposely didn't say anything after that, so it would just be silent, so you'd feel pressured to do more SpongeBob. And it worked. It worked. It did more. Do you think Kenny's ever masturbated while doing SpongeBob? Do you think he's ever had sex and done the SpongeBob voice during sex?
No.
Yes, he has.
No.
I feel like that probably
Tom Kenny has fucked his wife and done the SpongeBob voice.
Yeah, and she's
like, it's just as a joke. It's a friendly little...
Yes, and then she'd say, fucking stop
it. She's like, Tom, stop
it. Okay, I'm sorry.
Tom, stop.
Fuck you, Tom.
Oh, and he's like...
I like it when you hit me.
I can't do SpongeBob's voice worth shit.
Remember my... Oh, I didn't mean the shift con... Whatever.
Dang it.
I'm gonna leech seed on your ass, bro.
Dude, Connell's got big orange nips on the side of his head.
Does he?
I don't mind.
I don't mind?
The way, like, some anime tits are drawn, where they got the real shiny nipples. Kind of that's what they look like.
Okay. I mean, he's gone now, so I can't really check.
But, Holes 2 looks like something out of WALL-E, like a little floating robot.
WALL-E!
That's probably the best impression I can do.
Tom Kenny should have done WALL-E's voice.
Probably did. It sounds just like him.
Excuse me.
Imagine WALL-E laughing like SpongeBob. Dude, imagine like some kind of like erotic fan fiction where it's WALL-E and SpongeBob.
Where it's WALL-E and SpongeBob?
Yeah, you know, like WALL-E's the last little robot on Earth. You know how lonely he is because he's friends with a cockroach. SpongeBob, the conspiracy theory is that SpongeBob came from a nuclear test in the Pacific, and that's why Bikini Bottom exists.
Yes.
Because it's like Bikini Atoll, which is where they did nuclear testing, so that's the theory. So maybe SpongeBob climbs his way out of the ocean onto the coast, and then he meets up with WALL-E, because it's like, they go together, you know, nuclear destruction and stuff. Mm-hmm. SpongeBob, WALL-E, it's all the same. And then they could have some kind of like romance together with SpongeBob and WALL-E, just really fall in love. I'd like for someone
like
to create
idea.
That. Yeah, you like it?
Yeah.
Sony Pictures or someone, you could buy that from me.
You know, Illumination, probably would be better. They're my favorite animation company.
Dude, if they made a SpongeBob WALL-E crossover where they're in love, I'd be all over that.
We should play Puyo Puyo while he's gone.
I'd like to.
Why'd you go back to their apartment? Play some video games.
Because he'll die because of my dog.
Yeah, I'll fucking die from Lego.
I forgot. Come over to... No, don't come
but
over.
But you love
there.
Lego.
Oh, we got... Oh, no!
What?
I meant to... Oh, hold on. No, it's okay. I can... It's okay.
Matt, their screamings are making my headache better.
I brought you the magic skill called Agile.
He skipped the cutscene.
It's okay. I can find it again.
Why'd you skip a cutscene?
Where is it?
Matt,
is
open
here?
It for me.
It's
why is the angry
was,
video game nerd there?
I was trying to pause it. There he is. I was trying to pause it.
There you go, Ryan.
And I fucked up. I'm sorry. It was the one where he dies. I like that one a lot.
Where the dad's sick.
Yeah.
Here, I can take it from YouTube and cut it in right here. Yeah.
Okay, now comment over it.
I really like when he falls down. I think it's a lot of fun. I think it's funny.
Okay. I mean, I have no idea what's happening right now.
It's, what is it that he goes to confront his dad? Or no, that would have been this
He's
one.
Outside his dad's room and he's all nervous.
Yeah.
Right?
So that's the one we just skipped then.
Well, no, I played
that's
it.
Good, so
I'm
I
putting this
to
commentary
see.
Over it.
Yeah, you're watching it right now.
Oh, there it is. Wow. It's look at SpongeBob. He's so big.
And I just had to...
He's getting bigger.
Did somebody say SpongeBob? I'm paying attention now.
Is that Plankton?
All right,
Plankton's
back.
In the video
nope,
too.
We're back to this now.
I'm gonna have to take a bit of a poo-poo break after this.
Yeah, you can, dude, feel free to go release yourself after I beat this boss. Ready?
I'm ready. What happened?
Forget
wait,
that.
What
just
happened?
Wait. Just pretend like it didn't happen.
Yeah, yeah.
Just wait. Just hold on, man. I'm trying.
I'm ready. Call me SpongeBob, because I'm ready.
Got him!
SpongeBob SquarePants!
Matt, you found this game, and what happened? What was my reaction?
Okay, so, well, we're looking for a game to play today, and I'm going through this bin that's kind of like in the corner of the room with a bunch of trash games.
Yeah.
And I find this little Game Boy Color cartridge that has some kid's initials written on it, and I was like, SpongeBob SquarePants, The Legend of the Lost Spatula. Okay, Ryan, you want to play this? And your face lit up, and you had the most, you know, enthusiastic just explosion of energy I've ever seen.
The thing is, like, I forgot about this game completely, and the moment you showed me the game cartridge, I was rushed back to a time where I spent hours upon hours on this game being frustrated, and from my remembrance, I had a good time because I kept playing it. For all I know, this could be a bullshit game, and I could have that Billy Hatcher sensibility to it.
The Billy Hatcher syndrome.
But, hey, it's SpongeBob. He hasn't let us down before.
Never.
Besides the
second
recent
movie. Yeah.
And the other movie.
Jesus Christ.
But the first movie still
holds up.
I like it.
It's still good. So got some funny jokes. Let's play it,
yeah,
dude.
Let's just go.
Oh, there it is. Welcome, my friends, to Bikini Bottom. Got to do in SpongeBob's voice, Ryan. SpongeBob.
Let us join SpongeBob!
I love that. I love it. Just let us join SpongeBob. Let us.
Look out, SpongeBob! There's something. Uh-oh.
Shot in the face. What is this? He has uncovered something. When I said, what is this? I wasn't reading the text. I was actually saying, what is this? And then I saw it was the text, so I went with it.
Wow, Mr. Krabs will know what this is.
How is Mr. Krabs supposed to know what that is?
This looks like it was drawn in, like, Microsoft Paint, doesn't it? Like, someone actually took the time in Paint to do this. But, like, they could have done better than this on the Game Boy, right?
Absolutely. I remember didn't the Catholic Church sue SpongeBob for promoting homosexuality?
Did they?
I'm not kidding.
Homosexuality?
Apparently. Hold on, let me look this up. I'm almost certain that the Catholic Church sued SpongeBob.
Ugh, fuck me.
Catholic Church SpongeBob. I'm on CatholicAnswers.com, and this forum
what
says,
are you finding?
It says, did Pope Benedict XVI say any of this? And,
oh, Jesus.
Hi, everybody. I recently read an article about a celebrity who left the Catholic Church, and basically her reasons for leaving the Catholic Church were this.
What were
the church
reasons?
Said, cartoon character SpongeBob SquarePants is gay, and he's a sinner, and he should burn in hell. And
what?
Harry Potter was a sin.
Wait.
Working women.
SpongeBob's fucking gay.
Y'all, SpongeBob gay as fuck.
The fuck?
Whoa. Tell a story while you do your thing. Don't even pay me no mind. Don't pay me no mind, Ryan. Just
okay,
do your thing.
Just tell your story.
One time, Tom Kenny, the creator of SpongeBob, was, he was in his bathroom one morning.
Is he the creator of SpongeBob?
Tom Kenny?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Tom Kenny voices SpongeBob. Well, you've derailed my whole story now, Ryan, and I'm not gonna speak for the rest of the episode.
I'm sorry. Fuck me! It's like they come right- like I have to inch my way through the screen.
Well, anyway, one morning, Tom Kenny was hanging out on his back porch, having his morning coffee and cigarette.
Oh, you bitch.
And, he got a call on his cell phone, and it was the director of SpongeBob, and he said, Tom, get to the studio right now, we got some serious shit to talk about.
Oh my god.
So, Tom got in his four-door Escalade, and he drove to the studio, the SpongeBob studio,
mm-hmm.
and they said, Tom, sit down, we gotta talk. So Tom sat down at the table, and he was like, yeah, what's up? And the SpongeBob director said, Tom, we let something slip. There was an editing mistake. The N-word got left in SpongeBob, and you were the one who said it. So Tom Kenny says, Oh my god, dude. That's what Tom Kenny said. Just that.
He said, oh my god, dude.
Yeah, and he said, we have 5 minutes until the episode airs, and we gotta rush to the studios and get it pulled from the system. So they all hop in Tom's Escalade and they start speeding down the freeway, down the Los Angeles 5. You know, they gotta get to Burbank.
They have to.
They gotta get to Burbank fast.
Well, oh my god, dude.
Then they get a call from Ryan, and he goes, I can't beat this game. It's giving me shit. And they say, all right, you know what? We got to stop and we got to come to the Game Grumps office and we got to help Ryan beat this SpongeBob game.
Yeah?
Fuck this episode. You know what? Mistakes happen. If it goes out, we'll deal with it. We'll get our PR people to make it right. So they come to the Game Grumps office. They sit down with funny Let's Play duo SuperMega.
Oh,
and they
I love
help
them.
Us beat this game 100% to completion. And they just get, they fix the whole inward thing with a simple tweet. They just say, hey, you know what? It's okay. We didn't mean to.
Oh, they fall when I step on them.
That makes sense.
That's fun.
Anyway, that's my story. That's what happened.
That was a good story.
Okay. SpongeBob goes to hell.
Bubbles!
Matt's dead now. It's just me.
You think when Tom Kenny dies, like, do you think his last words on his deathbed, he'll do it in SpongeBob's voice? Like, his son will be by his side, like, Dad, I love you. And he'll be like,
I love you too!
And when he takes his last breath and goes, bah! And dies.
Tom Kenny, no disrespect to you.
No, I admire Tom Kenny. What a meme. Alright guys, thanks for watching this episode of Flash Flood. If you got any good Flash games, let us know down in the comments. And we'll see you next time.
Bye.
Look at his fucking sunglasses.
Well, and the tree people, you're only a tree person in World of Warcraft if you spec
what are
in
they
a
called?
Resto.
What are they called?
Restoration Druid.
Are there? So they are druids. They're fake druids
yeah,
that
but
exist
in
the lore.
Not all druids
like
could do it in World of Warcraft.
Medieval shit.
I mean, they could, but
I'm not talking
useful.
About real old people who think they can do magic in the Celtic religion.
Well, you were confusing because you were saying like, oh, like, it couldn't be. It's not a real thing. And I'm like, but it
I
is
wasn't.
A real
that
thing.
Wasn't a diss. I found it interesting that people can study and know a lot about creatures that don't. And never
wow, this
did
is
exist.
A fucking stellar conversation. Maybe you should have my wife on because she could actually talk about this in great detail because she has a fucking medieval history degree.
I'd love to have your wife on, Ross.
Well, call her because she when I was leaving, she said, I'd like to go on their podcast. And I was like, yeah, I bet you would.
We'd love to have her on our podcast.
Why hasn't,
We've
why
asked
hasn't
her many
she been-
times.
Because you won't let her on the podcast, Ross.
I will!
Every time she tries to come in the room, you punch her in the face.
Look,
yeah,
she shouldn't be
and
here.
Say,
it's
get
a man's
out.
World.
This is a man. This is a man's world. Built by men for men. This recording room
hey,
is
I'm
built
man.
By
I'm also not so man. We are the men!
SpongeBob didn't teach you anything. It's now that we're men, we can do anything.
Dude,
now
I remember
that
movie.
Men.
That scene was fucking awesome.
What is that song teaching young girls? What is SpongeBob teaching young
what
girls?
Song
that they can't do
it's
anything?
It's only teaching men.
It's
fuck
where,
that movie.
It's
dude.
Where SpongeBob and Patrick put on like
oh,
seaweed mustaches
and
or something.
They become like manly guys.
Yeah, they're like, now that we're men, we can do anything now that we're men.
Yeah, dude.
I remember
that
the
movie,
Doopy,
right?
The Goopy Dooper, whatever song.
Yeah, the Goopy Dooper, Dooper song.
That's the one. I don't remember. I saw it once, and I was like, oh, that was interesting.
The Goofy Goober.
That's the one.
Yo, I cried during that movie, like
of course
in theaters.
You cried
like,
during
I,
when
every
they shriveled
movie.
Up in real
yeah,
life,
I
was like,
I cried.
Like,
oh.
That was
like,
sad. That was
how
a
old
sad
were
moment.
You guys?
I was probably like
when
14.
That, when did that
yeah,
come
that's
out?
Probably the issue.
I was like 13 or 14.
Were you only 14?
When did that movie come out?
That came out a while ago.
No, you would have been younger.
Yeah.
You think so?
Oh, yeah. I'm pretty sure.
Okay, SpongeBob came out in 1999, so I'm looking up the movie.
I was probably like 11?
It came out in 2004, so that is...
No way.
Like
2004,
SpongeBob,
I was
the movie?
14
I was
years
18.
Ago.
Wait, the SpongeBob movie came
no,
out
in 2004?
No, SpongeBob 18. SquarePants movie.
I was
dude,
8.
If I, yeah, it's exactly. I would have... Yeah, yeah, that's right.
There's no way I was
wait,
8.
You were 8?
Yeah,
eight.
I was...
Because I was 8 when Kangaroo Jack and...
Dude, 2004, I was 17. And I'm 30 now, so it's correct.
Wow. Oh my god.
Can you do a dolphin sound effect?
I can try.
Yeah?
Yeah, I don't think I've ever tried to make a dolphin sound, so this will be the first time
okay.
I've ever tried in my life.
Okay, go.
Alright.
Yeah. Dude, that was perfect.
Was that good? Did that sound
yeah.
like a dolphin?
That sounded like a SpongeBob dolphin hybrid.
I used to be able to. I could try SpongeBob's laugh.
Yeah. See, perfect.
Is that good enough?
Tom Kenny, you're out of a job.
Yo, Tom Kenny, I'm about to replace him.
If Matt can do SpongeBob's voice, then why do they need to be paying you?
And you know, again, you know, shout out to Tom Kenny's son who occasionally watches. SuperMega.
He might have grown out of
it. He might have been like, you know, these guys have said so many crude things about my father.
Made fun of his future death.
Which he brought up himself. Mac Kinney, Tom Kinney's son,
Brought up his dad's death?
No. He brought up the fact that in some AMA, he brought up that, you know, he's like, I don't want to know what they say about my dad. Because I don't even remember. We've said some pretty bad shit about Tom Kenny.
Yeah, but it's out of love.
Yeah, dude, I love Tom Kenny.
Yeah.
Except his Wikipedia picture looks like his face was like photoshopped onto his body. There's something weird with the lighting. I tweeted this out a while back. Like, it looks real weird. Like, the lighting on his face is opposite from the lighting on his body. I can't explain it. Go look at it.
I liked him as one of the gangster robots in Transformers 2.
He was in Transformers 2?
Yeah, buddy. He talked like this and he has gold chains and teeth and shit.
Really?
Yeah.
He was in Camp Lazlo. Remember that cartoon?
Yeah, I didn't like it.
I was never a big fan. I could watch it, but I was never a big fan. And you know what show I honestly was never really that into?
Like Brickleberry.
Brickleberry was bad. I watched one episode.
I couldn't do it.
I only watched it because I was like, oh, Daniel Tosh is in this.
He's like, what? Whoa, Daniel Tosh is epic.
And then I watched it and I was like, wow, I'm not a big fan of this show. It's not very good. Ryan, I've been thinking about what we were talking about earlier when we created the That's So Raven thing. And I really do think that we would do great in the field of writing for TV shows. So I was wondering, maybe we could practice a little bit. Just to show, what are you doing right now, Ryan? What are you doing? He stood up and he stretched his gym shorts, gave himself a wedgie so I could see both ass cheeks. What are you doing?
My underwear is weird.
That's how you fix it?
To make it worse, and then you pull it out of your butt crack.
Oh, okay, because I just saw you just, like, lean away from the mic and then stand up and basically give yourself a massive wedgie, revealing both of your glistening ass cheeks to me.
Well, I mean, if you wanted to take advantage of the situation, you could have, but you didn't.
So. All right, well, back to what I was saying. I'm sure that there's many Hollywood writers and producers that listen to our podcast, and maybe we should show them a little what we got. Let's start with something simple. What do you say we write an episode of SpongeBob live on the podcast?
Okay.
We'll take turns.
Okay. Do you want to start it off?
I'll start it off.
Okay.
All right. Interior. Pineapple. SpongeBob.
No, I mean, the episode has to begin, like, above the ocean, right?
Okay.
On that little island.
Okay.
Then it goes down in the bubbles.
Okay. Open with shot of island, and then pan down through bubbles to reveal SpongeBob Street with Patrick's Rock, Squidward's house, and SpongeBob's house. Interior, pineapple. SpongeBob is laying in bed. His alarm goes, and he sits up in bed.
Your turn. He goes, I'm ready, SpongeBob says, as he's already wearing his uniform for work because he's that excited. His hat falls down from the ceiling in this new contraption he made, so he's automatically ready. He puts his hand out, and all of a sudden this spatula arm comes out, and he goes out to reach for the spatula, except he grabs it. Nothing's there. The spatula's gone from the spatula machine.
Okay. Oh, no. My beloved spatula, Gary, where has it gone? Says SpongeBob. Gary, enter Gary. But instead of Gary, it's
Nermal.
From Garfield. It's Nermal from Garfield. And he meows at SpongeBob. And SpongeBob says, Gary, you're looking different today. All right, your turn.
Okay. So then SpongeBob kills both of them and leaves the house and knocks on Patrick's door and is like, Patrick, I can't find my spatula. Help. Ga, 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 ga. That's his laugh. I can't do it.
Where did the killing come from? It was so nonchalant. It's just SpongeBob kills both of them. And why would... Who's both of them? There was only Nermal.
And Gary.
Gary's not there.
Gary's somewhere, I'm sure.
Okay, he found him and killed him.
Yeah, he found him and killed him.
Okay.
Found him hiding under a bed.
Because he knew he was going to kill him. He's been threatening it every day.
I'm going to kill Gary soon, god damn it.
Patrick's rock lifts up to reveal Patrick sitting in his armchair, fully nude. He's erect and pre-cum is dripping down the shaft of his penis. Your turn.
Oh, SpongeBob, Patrick says. The rock closes back. But right before the last inch is shut, SpongeBob sees something shiny sprouting from Patrick's ripe asshole.
Wait a second. That was my spatula.
with shock, SpongeBob tries to lift the rock again, and then realizes that he can't because it's too heavy.
I better get Squidward to help me,
says SpongeBob as he runs towards Squidward's house.
The sweet sound of a
oboe? It's clarinet.
The sweet sound of a clarinet can be heard from an open window. SpongeBob starts yelling up at Squidward, but there's no answer. So then he does what SpongeBob does best. He runs up to Squidward's house and shoots himself through the window, not knowing Squidward was taking a bubble bath with his new fiance.
SpongeBob's jaw drops as he sees Squidward and Pearl in Squidward's bathtub. Pearl is fully nude and Squidward is also fully nude in the bathtub. He's playing her a beautiful song on his
clarinet ballad.
Just for her, because they're going to get married soon. Yeah. Squidward sees that SpongeBob has now entered the room and sees his fiancée nude, and this upsets him. And he goes, SpongeBob!
SpongeBob goes, wait, I can't explain! Patrick has my spatula up his cornhole! And then Squidward goes, SpongeBob, if I promise to help you get this spatula out of Patrick's corn butthole...
That's good.
Can I continue taking this bubble bath with my aroused fiancé?
SpongeBob goes...
Sure, Squidward, let's go.
So Squidward gets out of the bath and doesn't put any pants on because he doesn't wear pants to begin with. He just puts his shirt on.
Yeah.
They go outside and they go to Patrick's rock, and SpongeBob goes,
He's in there, Squidward.
Your turn.
Okay. Squidward tries to lift the rock like SpongeBob does, but nothing happens. He goes, well, that's all I got, and starts to walk away, but SpongeBob grabs one of his tentacles and goes, wait a second! Come on! Take this seriously! If I don't get my spatula, you'll be out of a job just like me! Squidward's eyes grow wide with happiness.
And he goes, hey, that doesn't sound so bad. And then he starts walking back, and his feet are making that like... sound that they make in SpongeBob, and then Squidward goes back inside and gets back in the bath. So it's just SpongeBob again. He doesn't know what to do. He's all by himself.
Patrick's rock is still closed. The only way he can possibly solve the problem...
Sorry, that was King Neptune sneezing in the background.
The only thing that could possibly even help SpongeBob is a scientific method of some sort. Mm. So he goes to a big fishbowl-like house with that Sandy lives in.
It's Sandy's house.
Yeah, it's just Sandy's house.
Okay. So SpongeBob goes inside of Sandy's house and he goes,
Sandy, I need help.
And Sandy climbs out of her little tree house and your turn.
She falls and breaks her neck and dies. SpongeBob then leaves sad. A funeral is held 2 months later. 5 months later, SpongeBob is sitting watching TV again. Sad. He's missed his spatula. He's out of a job.
Mr. Krabs fired him because he couldn't find his spatula. And he's now been unemployed for 5 months, and he's grown a beard. And he hasn't seen Patrick this whole time either. Patrick's just been in under the rock.
Yeah.
And he says,
you know what? Patrick's stolen everything from me. I'm going to go teach him a lesson.
So SpongeBob leaves his house and goes back to Patrick's rock, this time to really teach him a lesson he won't forget.
Okay. So SpongeBob begins to pull up the rock, and it's easier than before for some reason. But he can't quite fucking get it up. So he gets his trusty jellyfish net and starts to pry it open like a crowbar. He finally gets the rock open and finds Patrick's dead corpse laying there with a spatula in his butthole. Little did SpongeBob know, Patrick accidentally locked himself inside of his house when he closed it out of embarrassment after SpongeBob found him the first time.
End it, dude.
Distraught, SpongeBob goes back to his house. Makes a big salad and invites his family over. And they all eat the salad together. And then it closes with like one of those circles that closes in. And it's closing, and then it stops on SpongeBob, and he looks at the camera, and he goes,
"That's life!"
And then "That's Life" by Frank Sinatra starts playing, and it closes, and the credits roll.
Then you hear Santa Claus's sleigh go, ho, ho, ho. Because kids gotta, you know.
Santa, yeah.
Whenever Santa appears in something, it's like a really big
thing. They get
game. Excited. Didn't you get excited? Oh, by the way, let's round of applause.
Yeah, thank
for
you.
Us
that was our
that.
SpongeBob episode. Man, I would love to see you be a police sketch artist.
That would be great.
I would love to see that.
There had to be at least one case where my sketch helped, because it's like, oh, you drew his nose this goofy way, and it actually was that goofy.
I'd like to see, like, you draw this awful portrait of someone, but it turns out that's exactly what they look like.
Like Doodle Bob?
Doodle Bob. I saw a very compelling argument the other day about Doodle Bob from that SpongeBob episode.
What was the base argument?
So basically, SpongeBob, his pants... Or actually, it's a cube, because he's like 3D,
yeah.
Where Doodle Bob was 2D, so he's the one with the square pants.
He's the real SpongeBob.
He's the one with the
pants.
Square pants, you know?
Oh, wow.
What a show, man. SpongeBob SquarePants. I remember coming home from school, watching a little bit of SpongeBob SquarePants on the television set.
Still blows my mind whenever I look at it, and it started in, like, 99. I'm like, what?
Yeah.
I thought it started early 2000s, and I'm like, damn.
All right, Ryan, tell me a joke.
Okay, knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Banana.
Banana who?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Oranges?
Oranges who?
Orange, you glad I didn't say banana? Imagine SpongeBob with one of those things.
Mr. Grabs.
Like every character on SpongeBob, like
SpongeBob.
That's Squidward. No, Squidward's like
SpongeBob.
Can you do Hank Hill's voice with that?
Damn it, Bobby.
Wait, I gotta do the lower one.
Damn it, Bobby.
Damn it, Bobby.
I sell propane and propane accessories.
Ready for this?
Listen to this music, dude.
Okay, there's your shit. Now you get that ball. You know what you do? Turn into a bean on top of the ball and you wedge yourself there. That's something new. And then you push that on the button, then I can get out. And then there's another ball that I have that I don't know what to do with.
Just wait.
I'll just go up here.
I just realized every male character has a prostate gland.
Yeah.
And presumably a foreskin. So SpongeBob either is uncut or it's canon that he was circumcised at some point. Someone DM'd me on Instagram, and it was that picture of SpongeBob after he ripped his pants, but someone photoshopped like a perfect asshole, like a real human asshole onto him in the hole.
Hey, really?
It was disgusting. It was just like a pink asshole on SpongeBob. It was so like upsetting.
Is there another ball?
That's how you're done with the assignment. Okay. Draw a popular cartoon character. Please do not violate international copyright law.
SpongeBob.
Let's get some,
Dude.
Okay, I got the text tool.
I got this, yeah, please. I had this feeling last night where I was in bed about to go to sleep, and I was trying to think about what's the next thing that I want to get heavy into binging, and I'm thinking I'm just going to go back to season one, episode one of SpongeBob and start there.
Dude, SpongeBob's a great fucking show to binge.
So, like, I'm excited. And then, like, when it comes time, like, I'm going to watch the movie, and then that's going to end it.
Okay, so here's SpongeBob for you, Ryan. I'm going to draw a little SpongeBob.
I get to draw on the next level.
Okay, you can draw the next one. Oop. Fucked his eyes up a little bit. That's okay. He's smiling.
You know what part always kind of gave me the heebie-jeebies in SpongeBob?
What?
Okay, like, legitimately, I got scared during the hash-slinging slasher episode. Like, I muted my TV at some
point. Dude, that shit's freaky, man.
But,
blame you.
The point where he's like, your cleats are in my cornea! Like when SpongeBob's wearing the big old cleats to get into his like window.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. And the guy's fucking cleats.
Yeah.
SpongeBob's cleats go in the guy's cornea.
Yeah. No. He's like, my cleats are in your cornea. And he's trying to pull out his cleats that are like stuck in the dude's eyes.
That's a classic episode though. Like that is.
Was that post movie or pre movie?
Oh, that's early. That's pre movie.
That's when he has the bodyguard. The guy who's trying to kill him.
Yes.
Why
does
he
want to?
Why does he want to kill SpongeBob?
Because he doesn't, isn't he a hitman and he like mistakes him for someone else? I don't remember.
There's a reason, like he get, like SpongeBob gets on his nerves for some reason. He's like, I'm gonna fucking kill you.
That's what he says in the episode. I'm gonna fucking kill this sponge.
You nerd.
Sponge.
So SpongeBob's 17 or 19 or no, he's 20 something.
He's 24.
24? He's my age.
Yeah, dude, you're the same age as SpongeBob.
Dude.
How's my SpongeBob?
It's really nice.
Should I kill myself now?
Yeah.
All right, well, let's go.
Whee!
There he goes. You used some color. It's welcome back, Froshman.
Let's take a look at your work. All right, he's gonna analyze it. Oh.
Ooh, that's. Ooh!
Hell yeah!
Ooh! Yes!
We're back from being interrupted during our Let's Play. Is there like an inside joke in the office where it's like, guys, interrupt Super Mega while they're recording as much as you humanly can?
I think this is just how they can remain in the conscious of a lot of people. Especially like some people that maybe don't watch Game Grumps anymore, so they like every now and then like to trickle their brand in.
Yeah, oh I see. They're just trying to use our clout.
Yeah, because we're
fucking clout chasing.
I mean, first, you know, who was it? Disney or SpongeBob was trying to use us for popularity.
Yeah, because they knew SpongeBob was dying off, and they're like, hey, these guys are big.
So then they had to model the new SpongeBob and Patrick models after us.
Yeah. Which they didn't even get our permission for that or pay us any royalties, but you know, I like SpongeBob, so I'm willing to give it a pass.
Oh!
SpongeBob, that guy stole your ice cream cone.
Yeah. Yeah.
Now, why don't you fuck him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, come here!
It's like masturbating in public. Remember when the Catholic Church sued SpongeBob?
Did they?
For being, promoting homosexuality. Read about it on Wikipedia.
No.
Look it up, dude.
No.
Yeah, look it up.
Nope.
Ryan, I'm not kidding. Look it up. This is not what I'm fucking with you on. I'm serious.
Okay, so the Catholic Church did what again?
They sued SpongeBob. For promoting homosexuality.
So, Italy sued SpongeBob.
Italy?
The Catholic Church.
It's not in Italy.
Where is it?
The Vatican.
Yeah. Which is where?
Ow. Italy. Dumbass. Okay, Ryan, I want you to... Does this blow up if I hit it? Look it up. I'm serious. Look it up.
Okay.
This is not one of those times I'm fucking with you.
Yeah, I'll do it after the episode.
No, I'm serious. Do it right now. I'm not fucking with you. I know I've done this in the past where I tell you to look something up and you're like, no, I'm gonna look it up, but it's gonna be fake and you're gonna call me a dumbass.
Okay, how did SpongeBob promote homosexuality?
Saying that him and Patrick were gay.
I'm serious!
Ryan!
But SpongeBob
look
never
it up.
Said they were gay!
Look it up!
But SpongeBob never
I know,
said
they said
gay.
That it's making kids
did they,
gay, though.
Did they sue
SpongeBob
Sesame
is making...
Street? Did they sue Sesame Street with Bert and Ernie, too?
No, because they're straight.
The Catholic
it's
Church.
It's very canon that Bert and Ernie are a straight
SpongeBob
couple.
SpongeBob for promoting homosexuality
oh
between SpongeBob and Patrick?
Look it up, dude. Ryan,
why don't you look it up and show me?
Because then if I look it up and show you...
You have something to prove.
It doesn't prove it if I look it up. Because
if you have
look...
something to prove, then you gotta show me the evidence.
All right, I'll do it then. Ready?
The burden of proof is on your shoulders.
SpongeBob...
Gay Vatican.
Catholic Church.
Oh, no.
All right, I found it. I was wrong.
Okay.
Slightly.
Okay.
In 2005, an online video that showed clips from SpongeBob SquarePants and other children's shows set to the Sister Sledge song We Are Family to promote diversity and tolerance was attacked by an evangelical group in the United States because they saw SpongeBob being used to advocate homosexuality. James Dobson of Focus on the Family accused the video promoting homosexuality due to it being sponsored by a pro-tolerance group. And then Steven Hillenburg had to clarify that SpongeBob is somewhat asexual.
What?
Is he? So I was wrong. It was not the Catholic Church. I don't know why I thought that. It was Focus on the Family.
Has SpongeBob ever had...
Sex, yes.
Has he ever had a crush on the show? Did he ever, like...
Yes, he did.
What was the crush episode?
I swear, there was some episode where he's talking about getting married or he gets a girlfriend. Like, he had some kind of romantic interest, right?
I mean, I don't think... He's never had a continuous romantic interest in the show. It would be a one-off episode.
Steven
I don't
Hillenburg...
ever remember him having googly eyes.
Steven Hillenburg did say he was somewhat asexual, but that you know what that means? That means he's somewhat sexual as well.
Ooh.
So that means the creator has said in its canon that
SpongeBob is somewhat sexual.
I'm excited.
I like that.
Let me see.
No doubt.
After it came?
Look at the top.
All right.
That's a penis,
it's
right?
It's going,
See that?
It's sounding like, it's right fucking, now, dude.
Look at that. That's a penis.
And it's being sounded.
Okay, now, make sure you have a good view of it.
Yeah, oh my god, yeah, that really is. I took 100%. Damage just for that. Wow. Let me get this underwear. Here we go. Slap that fucking hand right there, baby. Slap me some fucking skin.
And the
skin.
Reason I bring that up is because artists and stuff have to, like, hide shit. Like, it looks like a penis.
Yeah, of course, dude. They knew what they were doing when they put that in. If they have a joke about penises in SpongeBob, then they realize that looks like a penis.
Then they know what penises are. Does the writing staff at SpongeBob know what a penis is?
This will be in our video essay about sex and gender within SpongeBob. Yeah, jump up here.
Penises have to exist because Patchy the Pirate, he is not an animated person.
He's a
but
human.
He shows up in the SpongeBob universe. And we can deduce that from our understanding of the human universe as we know it today, that Patchy the Pirate, in fact, does have a penis. And if he also exists in the SpongeBob Bikini Bottom universe, that means that penises do exist.
That does, yeah.
But do they exist on sea creatures?
Sponges.
So that's, let's look at our friend, Patrick. If you recall in an episode, if you recall in an episode, SpongeBob declares, Patrick, your genius is showing. Obviously, this sounds a lot like the word penis to
yeah,
which Patrick
Yeah, and he does get
responds.
Shocked. He goes, where?
If you watch this clip closely, slow motion, he crosses his arms over his crotch area.
Does he?
And exclaims, where?
Uh-oh. So penises do exist. However, you'd have to look up each creature to creature. Does a sponge? Sponges reproduce asexually.
Mm-hmm.
Starfish.
I'm sure
starfish are sexual beings, right?
Mm-hmm.
Squids, those are sexual. Those fuck. So yeah. Squidward fucks. Crabs fuck. Crabs yeah. aren't asexual.
So
crabs
Mr.
fuck.
Crabs fucks.
Mr. Krabs fucks.
Wait, you remember that episode where it's where the universes are kind of reversed and Plankton owns the Krusty Krab and Mr. Krabs is like the Plankton character?
Yeah.
And he comes in naked. Have you seen the edited photo of that where it's just
yeah, with his huge cock out?
Yeah.
Justin, put it up right here.
You're playing as Patrick now, though.
I am playing as Patrick. Look at this.
Yo, I hope Tom Kinney dies so I can replace him as the voice of SpongeBob.
Bubble bash all the balloons.
Yo, if Tom Kinney's son is listening to this, I do apologize for wishing death upon your father.
Did you wish death upon him?
I just said I wished he died so I could voice SpongeBob. But
dude.
I know that's not realistic because I know that Nickelodeon would not choose me. And also, I would be devastated if Tom Kinney
died. Is bubble
died.
Bashing this?
Bubble bash is with triangle, yeah.
You think Tom Kenny ever does, like, SpongeBob's voice when he's having, like, dirty talk, like, trying to be funny with his wife so he'll do SpongeBob's voice when they fuck? You know he does. I'm sure everyone that voices...
going down on her and...
Mm.
His son doesn't need to listen to this shit. Are we saying these things to spite his son? Did
no,
you
not
up
at all!
That subject to
no.
spite Tom Kenny's
no,
son?
No, not at all! I just
you
think
know...
You all, okay, you always hear those stories, it's like, yeah, this kid drowned trying to find Bikini Bottom. It's like, is that true? Did that ever actually happen? I need to Snopes that. Can you look that up on Snopes or something? Like, did a kid ever actually... Because when I was young, everyone was like, yeah, a kid tried to find Bikini Bottom and died. It's like, I'm sure there was one kid out there, but, you know, you can't blame SpongeBob for that.
Blame Tom Kenny.
Yeah, fuck you, Tom Kenny. I'm just
SpongeBob
kidding.
SpongeBob SquarePants death, Snopes. Claim, a child drowned after jumping into the ocean to see SpongeBob SquarePants. Status, false.
Ha, so I can laugh at it, because a kid didn't actually die. Tom Kenny, you're off the hook. I just want to say, Tom Kenny, if you're watching this, I love you so much, and I hope you enjoy our SpongeBob series. You're a sweet man.
If you want to hold the camera for one of our vlogs, we're always looking for people to, like, just pitch in and help.
Do some camera work, so...